and why we do integration testing. Okay, today topic is integration testing. So if you, why integration testing is required? If you are developing the any project, is the developer is developing this website, so every website having the modules. Just consider this is the login module, this is your home page, this is your registration page. I'm just giving the example, okay? So this is your add cart, and this is your, you know, payment gateway, and this is your final status. Like, just consider, this is not an actual module, right? Login page. I did not share my screen. I shared my screen. It is not visible. One second. Okay. You guys are not. One second. So, you guys are able to see my screen? Able to see all of you my screen? No. Okay. Just one second. Okay. This is the some issue with network. I don't know your side or my side. So what I can do, I will call you once and disconnect the call in your side also. Okay, I'll call you. Okay, this is your registration page. This is your like cart, and this is your payment gateway. And this is your like, you know, final status, like you are getting the final, you know, status message. So if you will go in the application, any application, you can take it like Facebook or anything like Amazon. So this application having the different module. So first module, you can see, I just will go through like layer of the modules. So if you will go in this page, so we have a login module, just consider, or return order module, or try primary prime. Okay, this is the cart, right? So these are the application. So when requirement will come, just one requirement came for new project came. So all the requirement we have, right? So this whole requirement, they will divide into the modules. When they design the application, that SDLC I already discussed in the last session. Okay, so what happened, they are dividing into the modules. This is the modules. Okay, so they divided into the modules. So what the developer can do, right? So you can see how much big application is there, this Amazon, right? So we have a big team for the development team for this application, right? So what they can do, they will divide all the requirement into the modules. Okay, this is your M1 M2, M3. So every module, one developer is taking care. Developer 1, developer 2. Okay. So, like while developing the application, we have a 40 team, you know, team member in this while developing this Amazon application. So, 40 developer having the 40 modules. Then what happened? Every individual developer is developing the application, modules, right? But how to integrate this module? Got it, right? So they're doing the integration between the one module to another modules. After integration of this modules, it will test this, you know, data communication Okay, when you are logging the page, this module is properly working or not. So we are integrating from one module to another module, and we are checking the data communication, this module is, you know, working properly or not. This is called integration testing. So we have a different way to perform this integration testing. In this level of testing, developer develop the interface. Using that interface, they can integrate the multiple modules. So in order to test it is working as per our expectation, means developer expectation or not. In integration testing, individual software model are integrated logically and tested as a group. Okay, individual software model has integrated logically, they have integrated as per requirement and tested as a group. Okay, so integration testing focus on the checking the data communication amongst these modules, right? So if someone will ask what is the integration testing, just give the one example. Okay, we have a one application, so that application is divided into the modules. So every module is having the, you know, I am giving the example, not like company is following, you know, one developer is developing, might be one module, they are developing the three or four developer also. Just I have given the example, right? So we have a multiple modules and we are going to integrate that modules and doing the, you know, testing it is working properly or not. Got it, right? So why do integration testing? So each software model is a unit tested defect still exists for the various region. So someone will ask why we do integration testing. Actually what happened, suddenly one more requirement will come, right? This Amazon application is developed, but you know, big millions day is coming, so they want to change, you know, in the home page they want to change some message will display the discount message. So login page, home page is the right one, module is already developed, but this suddenly requirement will come, then developer will start to change the coding stuff. Then what happened, one module they have changed, but here not doing the unit testing. So last session I already discussed regarding unit testing. So if you are not aware of unit testing, just go through the previous video session. Got it, right? So so what happened, the developer did the changes. So what is the unit testing? When you are developing the any application, means source code, then developer is doing the unit testing to test the major functionality is working fine or not, major cause. So they are, how they are doing the unit testing, they will develop the one piece of the code and they will test all the functionalities working properly or not. Last session I already discussed this, but for your understanding, just I can give you, this is if you are not aware of coding, nobody, just I am going through this unit testing. Okay, what is actually unit testing? So just consider this is the application I'm going to develop. So we have a logic, we have developed the functionality of login page. Right, this is your login page. We have developed the functionality of login page. Now again going to develop the functionality of home page. Okay, so this is your functionality of home page. this is the modules. Just consider for integration testing, just consider this is the module, but I'm going to the unit testing. What actually? So this is your cart, right? So this is your cart functionality. Okay, so this is your cart. So they have developed all the functionality. So developer is developing the application, and they have developed all this functionality. We have a multiple functionality. Now after developing this code, they will test the functionality is working properly or not. So they are not testing any functional related stuff. They are testing the logical stuff is working properly or not, right? This functionality, hey, this functionality they have developed, this if I will enter username and password, then home page will display like that, right? So after that, what will we do? They will write one a small piece of the code. Actually, when you will start the Selenium, we are doing same thing, but we are testing the functionality, we are not testing the logic. So this is your unit testing. So unit testing is a piece of the code. So developer will write a piece of the code and will check the functionality. Okay, so might be, so actually in the real time we have a test annotation. Okay, so here what we can do, just you can, I consider the test case one. Okay, so don't understand this coding stuff, this is not for your syllabus. So this is your Java stuff. So just I'm going to tell you what is unit testing. So what I can do, we will test all the functionality, it working properly or not, right? So what I can do, just will create an object. Just I am giving the example, so you will learn Java, you will get understanding this stuff, but here I'm going to access all this functionality is working fine or not. Not executing this code because this annotation will not work here. Just considering this, so this functionality I'm going to test here. Okay, so in one test cases I am going to test all the functionality. Got it, right? So just will test. So what happened actually? So what is the unit testing? So unit testing is a small piece of the code done by the developer. So developer will check the major functionality is working fine or not. So when it will execute this code, this all this functionality will test it. Might be here we have 100 functionality, right? So here we can make it the multiple test cases also. This is another test case, test. So they are checking the back end stuff, they are not checking the front end. Means front end means this is your functionality. So what UI you are testing is like it is working fine or not. We are not testing this login functionality, you know, functionality we are not testing. So we are testing the UI part and logic like output. We are not worry about of the coding stuff while doing the manual testing. We have a client requirement, so our while testing this application, it match with the client requirement, it is working fine or not. If it is not working, then test case is failed. If it is working, test case is passed, right? So this is, you know, unit testing. So last session I already discussed this, so no worry about that. So why we need, you know, why do integration testing, right? So this home page, Big Billions, they came, they want to add some discount here. So developer is added here some discount. Okay, like some discount they have added this, right? So what happened, this code is changed, right? So what happened, every time developer is not doing unit testing. Okay, so what happened, while you know the time of integration, it will test it. So each software module is a unit tested, defect still exist. Okay, might be developer did unit testing, but defect is already there. It is not sorted out properly, means it is not fixed properly, right? So still defect exists. So various reason. So various reason. This is the one reason I told you regarding the, you know, integration testing. A model is general, is designed by the an individual software developer whose understanding programming logic may be differ from the other programmer. So integration testing become necessary to verify software modules work in unity. At a time of module development, there are wide changes of the requirements. This is the one reason for unit testing. Every software engineer, every developer having the different logic and different stuff. So while integrating the modules, one module to the another module, it is mandatory to do the unit integration testing. Second is your module development. There is a wide changes of the requirements by the client. So this is the one changes I told you in this home page module or home page functionality. So this is the second reason to do integration testing. So integration test cases are differ from other test cases in the sense of it focus on the mainly for interface and flow of the data information between the modules. So I have given one example. So check the interface link between the login page and mailbox in our Gmail application, right? So I have given login page and mailbox. Check the interface link between the mailbox and delete mails module. Check the interface link between the compose and sent mail, right? If the mail inbox is reported as a spam, okay. So just I have given this how to, you know, some example of that. Then appear in a spam link and check the same mail in a spam link. Now the mail will not be shown in the inbox. If it is in the spam, okay, so it won't be there in mailbox. Try to forget password and check the notification of mailbox. So when you are doing the reset the password, your one link will come, right? So it will check it is you did you get that link or not. Check if the mailbox is straight, then it will show in the mail straight. Just I have given that example of Gmail, so you can find the integration scenario from here. Can you write 5 scenario for integration testing? So if you are logging this, then home page will open, or you can take the another like add cart like that. Just think once. You can make that scenario for first for just see this application, just see this example, just find the scenario for Gmail application or Facebook application and try to find like some scenario for the integration testing. Here we understood why and what is the integration testing, right? How to do the integration testing, right? So while integrating multiple modules, developer can follow any approach. So we have a top down approach, bottom down approach, hybrid approach or sandwich approach, big bang approach. Okay, actually this testing mostly done by the developer and okay, we are not involved inside this, right? So they are following the different approach, but if you will go in the interview, they will ask all the questions related if you are doing or not. You should be aware about of that. So you won't be do any. If you will go as a manual tester, your work is not too much. This is learning many things for your knowledge purpose, so you can understand the testing profile in the company. Once you will join the company, so they will ask, hey, can you do this type of the testing? So you should know, right? Okay, they told you you have to do unit testing, then you should know, right, what is unit testing and all. But tester are not doing, developer are doing this type of the testing. We are testing the only functionality of the application. So if you will, so what is your job? Once you will get the job, then what will happen? They will give one documentation regarding the application. Right, application leak, you know this emergent, right? But they're having a some another domain, right? So I don't know about of this how this application is working. So they will give you the KT regarding this application, and mostly the company having the documentation, but I can observe that many company doesn't have any documentation. So it's very difficult to understand the flow of the application. If you will not understand the application, then what happened? You're not able to test properly. So first you have to understand the application. Means domain knowledge you must be there, right? So then after that, there every company having the one template. You have to find the test scenario and write the test cases and will check the functionality properly working or not. If it is not working, then you have to contact your team lead or your senior, what is there in your team, senior member, hey, this is really defect or not. If defect is there, so every company having the one tool that is called defect tracking tool. So defect tracking tool, you have to give all the information, like I enter this, just consider it is not working, add cart is not working, then you have to tell to developer, hey developer, this, you know, I click on this, so you have to write all the information regarding this add cart is not working properly. We'll take the screenshot and we'll explore the things, hey, this is this functionality is not working, please look into that. And so defect having the also the priority, right? High priority, low priority and medium priority. So what happened? High priority means what? If you will enter this URL is not working, so this is your high level defect, must be fixed as soon as possible, otherwise we'll lose, you know, huge loss is there, right? Might be if you are entering this Amazon website and it is not working properly, got it, right? So what happened? This is the high level defect, because it impact on the business, huge losses is there, right? So this is also divided, but all the things I will teach you in the coming session. So we are learning now type of the testing, okay? So it's not a big deal to work in the company, but big deal to the crack the interview, right? So everything you should know. And I am not asking the question from today, but next weekend I will ask the question. You guys will explain the thing. Otherwise, I will stop the session there only. So you guys also help me whatever I am teaching you. Otherwise, it will waste your time. Okay. So how to do the integration testing? So we have a different way, like top down approach, bottom up approach, hybrid approach or sandwich approach, and big bang approach. So what is the top down approach? In this approach, in which one will develop the parent module first, then the child module. In this same manner, only they are integrated. Just consider, this is your parent module and this is your child module. So in this approach, what you can do? In this approach, once one will develop the parent module first. So first it will develop this one, then it will develop this child module, got it, right? So this is called your top down approach. Bottom up approach, in this approach one will develop child module first. So it will develop first this module, child module first, then it will develop parent module. So this is called your bottom up approach. We have a hybrid approach. It is a combination of top down and bottom approach, both they are doing, that is called hybrid model. Big bang approach, so whenever all the models are running, then they are integrated at a time. Okay, if any models is not yet completed, they are waiting for that and then only are integrated in all the models. Got it. So this is the best approach, because this parent and child, we have a take many times, but this one, you know, develop the application and integrating this. But here one more disadvantage, not yet completed, then they have to wait, then only they will integrate. So it depend upon the requirement will approach this type of the, you know, tools while doing the integration testing. So how to do that? So we have a stub and driver. All the things they will ask in the question. Okay, interview question. What is integration testing? Why integration testing? Who will do integration testing? How to do integration testing? When you have to do integration testing? And what is the types for the integration testing? Okay, so a stub, what is a stub? So whenever mandatory model is not yet developed into the top-up approach, to overcome this approach, they are using temporary program calling as that stub. So what is a stub means, one module is not yet developed, then they will make it like some dummy code or dummy, you know, they are using the temporary program for calling as a stub. So one of big models are there, but it will take time to, you know, develop that. So what happened, they will make it a small code or a small dummy code for testing the another modules, right? They will test that, they won't be wait for the till that model is completed. That is called the stub. Driver means whenever the mandatory model is not completed in the bottom approach, the approach to overcome this problem, they are using temporary. So this is for top and this is for bottom, for using some temporary code or dummy code. So that is called driver. So this is also the interview question, what is the stub and what is the driver. We have a system level of testing. So in this level of testing, one will be the different type of the testing of the application in a very important, and one in the actually system level of the testing, different, I mean in system level testing we have a different types of the testing. So I will come on that, because system testing is mandatory for the application. Okay, so I will come on that to explore the system testing. So in this level of testing, one will do some achieving the one model that will be the reflecting to the corresponding related model or not. Okay, they can test it. So we have a, I will come on this system level of the testing. Okay, so we have a user acceptance testing. User acceptance testing means in this level of testing, test engineer can test the application in front of the client before delivering the to application. So this Amazon, this is the TCS, you know, Amazon is the client of TCS, got it, right? So some enhancement they did. Okay, here some enhancement they did for in modules, or just consider they have added or they have developed the application. Now the TCS people tested this, all the functionality or application working properly or not. Okay, so in this level of testing, test engineer can test the application in front of the client before delivering to the, you know, client means, so before, now what happened? So TCS people have tested again, you know, in front of the client, in front of the Amazon people, TCS people have tested this application and it is working fine or not. But you know, before they will, after that Amazon guy also test the application, then they will release the application in the production. So how to do that, this testing? So we have a alpha testing and we have beta testing. So we will discuss this. Just give me 1 second. So alpha testing, what is alpha testing, beta testing? I will discuss in the coming session. System testing, alpha testing, beta testing. Okay, so here user acceptance, before delivering the application we have to test in front of the client, that is called user level acceptance testing. So types of the testing, again I will come on that. Okay, so just I have given the overview of this, but integration testing I have discussed in the complete, whatever, you know, the process of the integration testing. Okay, so we have, So delivery means company to client, okay? So release means same organization. Got it, right? So what is the meaning of delivery and release? So they are using two words. Delivery means company to client, TCS to Amazon, and release means Amazon only. They are releasing this product, they are releasing this application. Got it, right? One person to another person in company, right? So if you will go in the real time, we have a different environment. So a combination of hardware, basic software, and which hold the application. Got it, right? So we have a different environment. So while the developing the application, we having the layers. So that is called presentation layer, business layer, or database layer. This is the part of, you know, when development is started. So this is, you know, having the this type of the layers. I will come on that. Presentation layer, business layer, and database layer. So types of the environment. So we'll give you that example of this. So single tier architecture or a standalone application. So we have a two tier architecture or client server environment, three tier architecture or web environment, n tier architecture or distribution environment. So single type of architecture, that is called a standalone application. It is having a single tier, which representative or presentation layer. Got it, right? So this is called your presentation layer. So single type of architecture means a standalone application, VLC player, antivirus, operating system. This is the example of a standalone. A standalone is nothing but this is your presentation layer. So it is having the single tier, only one users can use at a time. Antivirus, one users are using at a time in your system. VLC player, right? Operating system, right? So this is called your single type architecture, a standalone or presentation layer. Whenever one application are using single user at a time in a standalone environment, we can choose the single type architectures, business layer and database layer. Okay, so two tier architecture, it is having the two types. One is your client and one is your server. So which is having the presentation layer and business layer, and which is having only database layer. Okay, so in the client we have a presentation layer and business layer, and here server, which is having the only database layer. Client and server means what I can tell you, right? Just this is the part of development step whatever I'm going to discuss, but you should have a knowledge of that. Okay, you know, we have, just you can consider the Facebook. So Facebook we are using, right? So when you are entering username and password, so Facebook having the different, you know, multiple servers. So what will happen when you will enter username password, it will interact to the database through the servers. Okay, so client is your what? Facebook. Just consider that this is not like real time stuff. To develop any application by using the following specification, then we can use two tier application. Okay, so within the organization only we can using the application. Okay, where you can use this? All client having the sharing same database, they are expecting the speed, no need to worry about the security and business layer. ATM company or call ticket reservation. So this will come in the two tier application. So three tier means your web application, it is having the three, you know, tier. Okay, spelling is wrong. Okay, so client and application and server, which is having only presentation layer, which is having only business layer, and which is only having the database layer. So in the three tier application having all this layers, right? Client, application, and actually I am using the Facebook, right? So when you are entering username password, then we have some business logic, right? Then you're hit into the database. Just I'm giving the example, right? So having the only presentation layer. Now you having a business layer means logic, business logic. Like you are adding the cart, you are adding the product. So we have a business layer. Business means this, when you are adding or deleting, some business logic is there, right? That is called business layer. Database, you know, when you are adding your product in your add cart, then it will, if you order this, then it will store in the database, right? So we'll get the notification to Amazon people. In the database, they will see, oh, this order, we got it. So this is the three-tier architecture. So whenever one application are using worldwide, like internet, more member, people, then we choose the web environment, right? Like Gmail or internet. We have an N-tier of architecture also. It is same like the web page environment or worldwide through internet. We can accessing the application huge number of the people. So here we will use a many number of the peoples, right? You can take the example of Facebook here also. It is same like that, but here we have a more and more traffic. Got it, right? Million of the peoples are using this application at a time. Right, overcome reducing burden and improve the performance, reducing, okay. And now we can choose the distribution environment, right? So N-tier application having the huge users, like millions of the users. You can take the example of Facebook, Amazon also, like Flipkart application. So this is the overview of, you know, internally environment of the application and types of the application. Recently they will ask in the interview, what is the standalone application. One of my students was attending the interview. She went as a interview as a automation tester. They asked, hey, what is the standalone application? So they can ask any type of the question which is related to the application or testing. Okay, so now again I will come in the testing steps. So just we have given the types of environment and just overview of that. So we have a types of the testing. So already we have discussed some types of the testing. What is called software build? Have any idea about of that? Software build. Okay, so this application is developed. This application is developed. I did not, you know, execute this code. I did not compile, I did not execute this code. Simply, this is developed, this application. So this is called your source code. Okay. When we have developed the application and execute the application and compile the execution and execute the execution, you know, that is called in technical language, that is called build. Okay, got it, right? What is build? So application is developed. I did not compile, I did not execute. That is called source code. Application is developed. Then after that, they executed, compiled the code and executed the code. And still this application in the development environment. So that in the technical language, it is called build. So if you are developing a simple computer program which consists of only one source code file, if you are merely need to compile and link this one file to produce an executable file, this process is very simple. That is called executable file also. So usually this is not the case. A typical software project consisted of hundreds, what I have written, 100 and 1000 of the source code file. Just if you have a one simple file, right, that you have executed and you have made the, you know, executable code. But we have 100 or 1000 of the source code file, right? Here we have 100 classes, Right, 100 classes you have developed this application. It is very difficult, right? So we'll go to one and all this. Then what happens here? Creating an executable program for this source file and complicated, is very complicated and time consuming task, right? So you need to use build software to create an executable program and process to call the software build. What I have mentioned, same thing I have mentioned in the technical word. So what happened if you have 100 classes? 100 classes, how to, you know, it's very difficult to, like this application we have to deploy to the testing environment or product, or product environment, right? Production environment. Then how to do that, right? So we cannot execute the code one by one, right? So they have executed all the code and they will make it like executable program, and this process is called, you know, just consider we have a huge library and that code will convert it into the jar file. I can show you this what a meaning of build, but just I'm not, this is just example purpose. So if we will go in this where I kept this, yeah, this is your source code, right? So if you will go in the source code Java, you can, we have a multiple package, right? If you will go in this any package, so we have a multiple classes, right? This is the multiple classes is there. So just I'm going to one classes. A string or what? Okay, this is the one classes I'm going to that, right? But if you will develop, if you will, you know, install the, this is the JDK Java part, right? If you will develop, you know, sorry, if you want to use, you know, Java software JDK, then how to get this all the code, right? So they have given one software they made is JDK software. So JDK is a what? Just consider it is a one type of the build, one executable file. If you will install in your system, if you will install in your system, so already this, you know, folder is there, JDK. Right, in JDK this, all this executable file is there. Right, so just software is developed, we have 100 or 1000 of the, you know, Java classes. They have bind it in one executable file, that is called build. Got it, right? So this is, you know, this is called your software build. So what is a smoke testing? So after the build is developed, no, I explain this build stuff because I will use this build always. Okay, when they have binded all the things and executed and make it the one executable file, then develop, just before releasing the build to developer will check whether the build is proper or not. That is known as smoke testing. Got it, right? So after build, developer, you know, touch, okay, before releasing the build, build developer will check whether the build is proper or not. Okay, they have developed this build, okay, they have made this build, but before releasing this build to the testing environment, again developer will test this build is proper. Actually this all this code, right? This I have shown you, right? So all this, not this, this folder, where is that? Again I have to go in the source code, right? Java. So they have, you know, builded that it made it the one software like JDK, and again it will test, right, this build is properly working or not. That is called a smoke testing. Got it, right? So what is a smoke testing? After developing the build, before releasing, then this build deploy in the testing environment. So the developer will check this is properly working or not. You know, that is called smoke testing. So a smoke testing is a kind of software testing performed after software build to ascertain that a critical functionality of the program is working fine or not. It is executed before any detailed functional regression tests are executed on the software build. So before functional testing and regression testing, it is executed. It verifies that the critical functionality of the system is working fine or not. For example, the typical smoke would be verify the application is launched successfully or not. I told you, right, if you will hit URL of Amazon, then it will check it is working properly or not. Right, so this is called your smoke testing. So smoke testing done by the developer. So we have learned integration testing, smoke testing, unit testing. Last time we had already discussed. So you have all idea about what is software build, why we do a smoke testing, right? Who is doing the smoke testing? What you are testing in the smoke testing, right? So this type of the question they will ask in the interview. One more testing is called, that is called sanity testing. So more confusion is there for smoke testing and sanity testing, but we will understand that. So what is the sanity testing? Software build is done, but again they will come. What happened? You are not able to hear me? Hello?